take one example of a relation. So as I told you that relation, when I'm saying relationship means what is the association among different entities. Now consider this example. When we are saying every employee works for a department, every employee works for a department, and a department can have many employees. A department can have many employees, and new departments need not have any employee. New departments need not have any employees. Consider this example. Here you can see that the condition is like this. We have certain number of employees. Every employee has to work for a department. It is necessary and mandatory. But some departments may not have any employees if the department is new. So you can draw it like this. So this is representing the employees. Let me do one thing. This is representing the employees. This is representing their association. And this is representing the department. Okay. So assuming that we are having the employees as, there's an employee A1, there's an employee A2, there's an employee A3, there's an employee A4, there's an employee A5, and there's an employee A6. And assuming that these are the departments D1, department D2, department D3, and department D4. Now they are saying every employee works for a department. Here this employee is an entity. Employee is an entity, works for, is representing the relationship, and department is still an entity. Department is an entity. So you can take it like this. Every employee works for a department. So assuming that employee E1 works for the department D1, works for the department D1, employee E2 works for the department D1, assuming employee E3 works for the department D3, employee E4 works for the department D2, employee E5 works for the department D3, and employee E6 works for the department D3. Okay, so you can clearly see what is happening here. Every employee works for a department. So you can see, for every employee we assigned a department to those employees, and a department can have many employees. You can see department D1 and department D3 are having more than one employees, and the new department need not have any employee. For example, if you have the department D4, then department D4 need not have any employee. Now there are three things which you need to find. Number one, what is the degree of this relation? Second, what is the participation constraint? Participation. And third, what is the cardinality ratio? What is the cardinality ratio? Okay. So what is the degree? Degree is, in every relationship, how many entities or how many entity sets are participating? That is called as degree of a relationship. Okay, you can say, in every relationship, how many entity sets are participating, that gives what is the degree of that particular relation. How many entity sets are participating, that gives the degree of that particular relation. Here, how many entity sets are participating? We have two entity sets. Number one is employee, and the second one is department. So one is employee and second one is department. Therefore, degree of this relation works for is 2. So degree is 2. Next, what is the participation? Participation is, what is the minimum number of relationship an entity can participate, right? You can say what is the minimum number of relationship. Relationship, an entity can participate, that is called as participation. And this participation is sometimes also referred to as minimum cardinality. Okay, minimum cardinality. So if you find what is the participation of employee, what is the participation of employee, that means in what is the minimum number of relationship an entity has to participate. You can see for every employee, in minimum every employee has to participate in at least one relation, a minimum of one relation, therefore the participation of employee is one. Then if I ask you what is the participation of department, you can see a department, for example we have the department D4, department D4 is not participating in any relationship, therefore the participation of department is zero. Participation of department is zero. Next is the cardinality ratio representation, or you can say cardinality ratio. What is the cardinality ratio? Is what is the maximum number of relation, what is the maximum number of relationship. Relationship. See, there's a difference between relation and relationship. Okay, that you'll get to know at later point of time. So what is the maximum number of relationships in which an entity can participate, in which an entity can participate, that is called as cardinality ratio. For example, if I ask you what is the cardinality ratio of employee, or cardinality ratio of employee, you can see what is the maximum number of relationship an entity can participate. So every employee can participate on exactly one relationship, therefore the cardinality of employee is one. If I ask you what is the cardinality of department, cardinality of department is what is the maximum number of relation an entity can participate. Here you can see the department D3 and the department D1, they are participating in more than one relationship, therefore the participation for department is many. Or you can say it is N. Participation for department is many, or it is N. Now this participation is also called as existence constraint. Okay, right? And these are also called as structural constraints. These things are also called as structural constraints. Okay, so you can say participation or existence constraints, these are also called as structural constraints. Okay, so here you can see, again I'm repeating, in this relationship the degree is 2, therefore this type of relationship is also called as binary relationship. And here you can see in this particular binary relationship we have cardinality ratio representation and we have the participation representation, or we will be calculating participation. And when I'm saying participation is what is the minimum number of relationship an entity can participate, and cardinality means what is the maximum number of relationship an entity can participate. Now this kind of relation can be denoted by three representations. Number one, we have the cardinality ratio representation, the cardinality ratio representation. Number two, we have the single line double line representation, single line and double line representation. And number three is the min max representation. So let us do them one by one. The first one is the cardinality ratio representation. So here we had employee and a department and a relation which is works for. Okay, so here you can see the cardinality of employee was 1, the cardinality of department is N. So the in case of cardinality ratio representation, we write this 1 here and we write this N here, so you can represent it like this, N is to 1. Okay, The second representation is single line, double line representation. In case of single line, double line representation, we see what is the site where we are having total participation. What is the site where we are having total participation? And what is total participation? Is when at a particular site, the minimum cardinality is 1, then that is called as total participation. That is called as total participation. Okay, so let me write it again. Here you can see in the previous slide, you can clearly see here what is the participation of employee, it is 1, and what is the participation of department, it is 0. So here you can say the participation of employee is 1 and the participation of department is 0. So whenever the participation is not 1 or not 0 or it is greater than 0, you can say whenever the participation is 1, then that site is called as total participating site, and this employee is totally participating in this relationship. So this total participation is generally denoted by this double line representation. And the last one is the min max representation. So if this is the employee, and this is representing the department, and this is representing the relationship between the employee and the department. So in case of min max representation, we show what is the participation and what is the cardinality. The participation of employee is 1 and cardinality of employee is 1, and the participation of department is 0 and cardinality of department is 0. That is called as the min max representation. Means we are going to write what is the minimum cardinality and what is the maximum cardinality, what is the minimum cardinality and what is the maximum cardinality. Okay, so now let us look at what are the different kinds of relationships we have, like one-to-one relationship, one-to-many relationship, many-to-one, and so on, etc. Okay.